Hi, hi, class. I'm here. Good morning. Let's gonna start with the English class. So, today we're going to write a short anecdote. Round one. So, first of all, antes de comenzar con nuestro work, let's going to review our sequence words. Let's gonna make a review. So, sequence words that we can use to start telling a story. Palabras que podemos utilizar para start. We can use one day, one time. It start with or the other day. So these words, these expressions, we can use them to start. Estas expresiones las podemos utilizar para comenzar. To continue. To continue, we can use then, later, so, or next. So, next. To catch the attention. We can use suddenly, all of the sudden, but then. Remember the class when I told you the suddenly word? Okay, and to finish, we can write in the end, by the end, finally. Alright? These expressions are to finish telling an anecdote. So, can you write a short anecdote? Recuerda que las anecdotes las vamos a tener que escribir in past, como vimos la sesión pasada, utilizando simple past, o si tú conoces otro tipo de conjugación in past, también puedes utilizarlo, pero con simple past está perfect. So first, you're gonna think in a story you want to tell. First, we think in a story you want to tell. Pensamos en una story that you want to tell. For example, if you want to tell me that one time when you eat ice cream, okay? So, for example, if you want to tell me, si me quieres contar o quieres contar, that one time when you eat ice cream, esa vez que tú comiste ice cream, it's okay. Or that time when you ride a bicycle, cuando conduciste tu bicycle, or when you wear a costume, te disfrazaste, wear a costume, whatever you want, solo que no sea muy extensa, alright? So, a small one, una pequeña. Number two, start with a sequence word. You can start with one day, or one time, or it begin at the start. So, for example, you can tell me, one time my parents took me to eat ice cream. Recuerda que el ice cream no es que tú lo tengas que hacer de ice cream, solamente es un example. Okay? Number three, use sequence words. Utiliza sequence words. Puedes utilizar so, then, and suddenly. For example, ya dije mi inicio. One time my parents took me to eat ice cream. So, we went to Dairy Queen and I asked for a super big ice cone. Suddenly, my ice cream was on the floor. Y si te fijas, tu teacher está utilizando words in past. All right? So, important. Number four. Finish with at the end o cualquier otra sequence word que son para terminar. Vemos mi example. In the end, my parents scold me. They told me, you need to be more careful. It was so sad. So, tengo un beginning, a start. I have my sequence words to give my story continuity. And I have at the end, I have an ending. I have a finish to my story. Right? So, If you see this anecdote is short. Como puedes ver, esta anecdote is short. It's small. Okay? So that's an example of what you can do. Como tú puedes hacerlo. Alright? Remember, it doesn't need to be long. No tiene que ser muy larga. Algo con lo que tú puedas trabajar. Alright? Do not worry if you think it's wrong. No te preocupes. Don't worry si piensas que algo está mal. It's our first try. Es nuestro primer intento. Recuerda, it's round one. It's round one. Ya va a haber otros rounds. So, let's gonna work on that. Vamos a trabajar en eso. Goodbye and see you next week. Bye bye.